Oh, you may not know this, but Cursor actually includes docs by default that is indexed. You can simply search for docs and then hit enter and then search for something like Next.js. Now, in fact, if we look over here, you'll see that it's actually indexing, looking at individual indexed items to figure out how to actually do this. Server actions, form mutations. So it's actually indexed all those and now it's looking them up. But it may be that we need to interact with more from the actual live documentation. So I can say something like, make sure you check the, and then here you just want to use the web. Then you can search for whatever you want to find the most up-to-date patterns. All right, so I'm going to have it go search and just make sure that this is the way we'd want to do it. So if you have existing documentation, you can index that. If you want to look at something that's more recent to the framework, use the web command. The second thing I want to show you is how to index docs that don't currently exist inside of Cursor. I can add a new doc. I can click add a new doc here, and then I simply have to provide the name of kind of the base of the documentation. And what it will do is start to index the documentation. Now we can interact with those recent docs. So now it's going to use those docs that is just indexed to make sure that it can add everything it needs. Well, I hope this was a big help in understanding how to use Cursor to interact with documentation.